Let us see what is a matrix. A matrix is just a fancy term for a two-dimensional array. To create a matrix, let us see the documentation. Matrix belongs to base package, and here you can pass your data, n row, n columns. So by default it is set at 1. Let us see the arguments. So n row stands for desired number of rows, n col is for desired number of columns, by row it is logical if false or the default the matrix is filled by columns, otherwise the matrix is filled by rows. Let's pass just one argument and create a matrix. Here you can see it has created one by one matrix with one row and one column. The by default it is n row equals to 1 and n col equals to 1. Let's create a matrix with 3 rows and 4 columns. My data will be just a 0, so it will be repeated in the entire matrix. N row equals to 3 and n col equals to 4. Let's print. Yes, we are getting a matrix of 3 by 4. You can also use a vector to initialize a matrix value. To fill a 3 by 4 matrix, you'll need a 12 item vector. Let's create a 12 item vector A 1 2 12. Let's do control enter. Now let's create a matrix. Let's just print A just to confirm. Yeah. Now we'll call a matrix with the vector with the number of rows and number of columns. Let me just add a comment over here. Matrix with a vector. So it will be matrix. My data A, 3, 4. Let's do control enter. So the matrix is printed here. You can see the matrix is filled by columns. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, 11, 12. Let's try to create a matrix with rows. So we'll just make a, create a same matrix and do a by row equals to true. So it will be filled by rows, comma, by row equals to true. I'm telling you one more time, you can use either just a capital T, or you can just write enter true. I'll just show it to you. Make sure it is in the uppercase. Both are the same. If you can see the output over here, so it is the same matrix. The vector's values are copied into the new matrix one by one, as you have seen over here. You can also reshape the vector itself into a matrix. Let's try that. Let's create an 8 item vector. Let's make it as 8. You can use whatever name you want. 1, 2, 8. Let's print cache. Okay. So we'll use the dim operator, dim function. So the dim assignment function sets the dimension for a matrix. It accepts a vector with the number of rows and number of columns to assign. let's assign new dimensions to cache by passing a vector specifying two rows and four columns. Let's try dim cache. C, again concatenate operator C, two rows and four columns. Sorry, it's three, it's four. Okay, let's print cache. Here you can see it is converted into the matrix. Let's check the class of cache. It's a matrix. Let's check the dimension. By 4 meters.